Hello and welcome to the session of filtration in pharmacy. This is Suresh Kumar Paswan, assistant professor, faculty in pharmacy. Why we are discussing filtration in pharmacy? Because it's an important unit operation which is used in our pharmaceutical area, like aseptic processing or in preparation of syrup or solution or preparation of slurries and all, even in our advanced research laboratories, like preparation of solvent system for HPLC, or even in the separation of solid from liquid in bulk drug industry. So it's a very important unit operation in our pharmacy. So talking about filtration, it's a unit operation in which the solid is separated from fluid with the help of septum. This septum is called filter medium. The solid free fluid or the liquid which is obtained is known as filtrate, and the deposit of solid which is formed on the septum is cake. Talking about the theory of filtration, there are two, three theories which is used, applied in our filtration area, like Poiseuille's equation, Kahn-Zeigarnier's equation, or Darcy's equation. Talking about Darcy's equation, it is dV by dt, that is rate of fluid flow, is equal to Ka delta P, where K is a constant and A is the area, surface area of the filter media, and delta P is the pressure difference across the membrane, and mu is the viscosity of the liquid, and L is the thickness of the filter media. Talking about types of filtration, there are two kind of filtration, the surface filtration and depth filtration. Easily we can say like the screens which we are using, or cotton cloth we are using for separation or as a filtration, that is all known as surface filtration tool. And depth filtration, the candles or ceramic filters which are used in our household filtration unit, these are known as depth filtration. Talking about ideal filter medium, so what should be the ideal filter medium, or what kind of filter paper or what kind of assembly it should be? It should have the ability to retain very long range of particles, wide varieties of particles, even big particles, small particles, it should be able to separate out, and it should have a minimum resistance. It should not clog, or it should have minimum resistance for flow of the fluid. Should have ease of discharge of cake, like whatever the cake which is formed on the septum, or it should be able to discharge, and the media should not swell. Like in our pharmaceutical areas, we used to filter solvents, so the solvent generally they used to swell the filter media or the filter paper. So the ideal filter media, it should not swell, and it should withstand high pressure drop. Like in some cases we used to require nitrogen assembly for high pressure filtration. So at that time this filter media, it should withstand high pressure drops, and it should be chemically resistant. In pharmaceutical areas, the chemical resistance is very important. Like whatever the media we are using, or whatever filter media we are using, it should be compatible with the solvent what we are using, or what the solvent we are using for filtration. Talking about surface filter media, there are three type of surface filter medias are there. The screen type filter medias. The screen type of filter media, generally these are made up of synthetic, semi-synthetic, or natural filter paper filter assemblies. In screen type, like the woven cotton or muslin cloths, these are used as a screen type of filter. Even stainless steel filter screens are also used as filter media. In H type of filters, we are using stack of papers which are clamped, and it is having hole inside at in the center, and these are used as suction cup. The edge type of filter papers, whatever the material are there, they are left at the side of filters. And another one is stack disc filters. The stack disc filter, we are using different rings or washers. These are stacked on each other, and there are very fine clearance between the each disk, between the two disks. So there are a lot of disks which are clamped or stacked with each other, and they are used as filtration sample. And these disks are they are kept on the porous tubes. So these are all surface filtration media. Other one, deep filtration medium, depth filtration medium. These are fibrous medium and porous medium. The fibrous medium, these are made up of cotton clothes or cotton cotton membrane, and these medium are used as a depth filters, in which is a particle which they penetrate deeply inside it, and it get clogged, and so like that it can be used. And porous medium are like sintered glass are there, or sintered metallic steels are there. These porous medias are used as depth filtration. And talking about filter aids, these are the agents which are used to increase the rate of flow of fluid. These are generally like Kieselguhr, diatomaceous earth matter, charcoal, kaolin, asbestos, cellulose, volcano glass, perlite. Generally what happens, these materials, they are porous in nature. This Kieselguhr, this is a fossilized powder, in this fossilized powder, these are having porous in nature. Or even as you know, the charcoal, these are also porous in nature. So all this filter aid, these are porous in nature, and they form like a clog over the filter media or filter paper, and they help to increase the rate of filtration. They are used in they are used by two types, like body mix and pre coat. In body mix, what we used to do, we used to add 2 to 5% of filter aids into the slurry, and that slurry is filtered. And what happens, it prepares a clog, or it prepares a tortuous path for the liquid to be filtered, and it increases the rate of filtration. And talking about pre-coat, what we used to do is to prepare slurry 2 to 5% of filter aid, and we used to pre-filter this filter aid, and then it forms a cake over the filter media, and that is a porous cake. And in that we used to filter whatever the solution or we want to filter. Thank you for listening.